Hello from Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we'll discuss why stereochemical inversion occurs in SN2 reactions. Across the top of the screen, we have a typical SN2 reaction. Our nucleophile over the arrow is sodium azide. The starting material is a single enantiomer of a secondary halide, 2-bromobutane. The product is 2-azidobutane and reflects inversion of stereochemistry. There's nothing new here. Everyone learns that electrophilic centers are inverted during an SN2 reaction because the nucleophile attacks from the back face of the carbon leaving group bond. The question is, why does this happen? Why can't the nucleophile attack from other places? Why does it have to be the back face? To understand, we need to think about molecular orbitals. On the bottom left is an orbital energy diagram. This can match almost any orbital, but for us, it represents the carbon-bromine bond. Carbon, on the left, has an atomic orbital with one electron. The bromine, AO, on the right, has one electron. The two AOs mix to form two new molecular orbitals. The electrons fill the lower energy orbital. This is now a molecular orbital. This is our CBR bonding orbital, our sigma bond. The higher energy MO is vacant. This is our antibonding orbital, our sigma star. Towards the right, we can see pictures of these orbitals. These are probability representations, psi squared. The bonding orbital has its available region between the two nuclei. So electrons in that orbital are stable, happy if you prefer. The regions in the antibonding orbital fall outside the internuclear region. Here's a picture on the right of the CBR bond in 2-bromobutane, and we will draw the sigma star, the lobes of the sigma star, in this picture. The electron-rich nucleophile is seeking somewhere to place its electron density. Electrons go into orbitals, and the available orbital is the vacant sigma star. Can't go to the sigma because it's already full. That means a nucleophile needs to either approach from the bromine side or from the carbon side of this orbital, the sigma star orbital. The new bond is forming to carbon, so we'll approach on the carbon side. The sigma star lobe has 180 degree separation from the bromine, the leaving group, and that sets up the trajectory of the nucleophile. The nucleophile ends up on the opposite face as where the leaving group was located, and the stereocenter is inverted. So the inversion of stereochemistry in an SN2 reaction is driven by the molecular orbitals of the original leaving group. These molecular orbitals dictate the approach of the nucleophile so that the stereocenter is inverted.